Only 2 years old when daddy used to bring them hookers home. Looking like my grandma, my niggas got that ammo. We Jackson and then light up the L. Samuel.
Thank you. Well, thank you very much. I might be back again.
Okay.
Just a pretty face crop as well.
Today we toast to all these beautiful nerds walking among us. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Day one is finished. It's a Friday and they may move like it was a Saturday. So if this is their Friday, Saturday about to be crazy, man. I ran out of bags. I ran out of sizes on certain things. And Saturday is the big day. A good problem to have. Things go, money be made, debt paid off, more designs come in. It's a process, it's a routine. If it was up to me, I would drop all my designs one time and call it a day. But I gotta pace myself. So just stick with me for this growth, because it is a growing, you know, first time doing crop tops. So, you know, that's new. First time doing crop tops. And they're loving it, loving the crop tops. I'm almost sold out. I think I'm gonna sell out of all my crop tops before I leave DreamCon tomorrow. So after, oh, and today, DreamCon got actually really interesting. They have a mixer for all the exhibitors after this from 8 to 10:30. So once I'm done this, I close up shop and then I'm gonna hit that event and, you know, mix and mingle. It's like a networking event. So that's really good, because it's me being by myself. I don't really get a chance to walk around and talk to people and see what the, you know, with the competition looking like, if you feel what I'm saying. I'm kind of confined to my booth. But at that mixer, I'll mix and mingle. you know what I'm doing, try to find me a beautiful lady. That's something, you know, no, but I mean, I don't mean for work purposes, right? Right.
Because the extra large couldn't fit these hips. Like, you gotta have a 2X. I can't fit them.
Wait, okay, you said extra large in the shorts, right?
Yes.
Okay, this is the extra large right here.
Yeah, see? Wait, hold on. I gotta do the old grandma thing.
If you wanna put it on, you can. Vendor hall is closed. Time to see what this events about.
Why are you sweating so bad?
Element for me and hang it on your badge for me.
Gotta go with green.
Gotta go with color. Green. Alright, remember to hang that on your badge, okay?
Okay. That's pretty cool. And drinks, even cooler. Oh, this is nice. Oh, they really did that. Okay, so all the conventions that I've been to, they never had a part afterwards that say, yo, all the business people have a networking event. That is a great initiative. And then with the little perks that, you know, they said, don't open it until they tell you to pick a color. I'm guessing, you know, the color means something and they're going to announce it. They got food in here. They got drinks over there. This is really pretty cool. Like, I'm impressed. I've been to a lot of conventions and I'm impressed. So let me get me a drink, of course, and let's put this stuff together. Ooh. And is the food complimentary? Oh, let me get one. Thank you. I don't know what the fuck this is. This should look disgusting.
Hey.
It tastes like how it looks. I don't know. I'm not really that happy about it.
You don't even know?
I'm not really that happy about the beer.
And you're like, I don't like it.
It's different ones. So the one that I just did, I wasn't feeling it. But I'm going to try. I'm going to go down the list.
You're going to see if it's going to get better, hopefully.
Yeah.
What was the first one now?
It was like, it was like an olive. I think it was a black olive, like a purple olive.
Yeah. No. I'd be disappointed in that
one. I mean, it don't look that.
Like, it looks like a marshmallow. That's why I'm like, is it sweet or savory? Like, or is it like a potato? It's a marshmallow.
It's not a marshmallow.
What is it? A cheese? Oh, it's probably mozzarella. It's a mozzarella ball.
Yeah. I'm not really impressed.
It's better than before, maybe. Better than the olive.
So better than the olive.
It wasn't better.
It looked like a pepper.
No, it's tomato. It's a tomato. That's artichoke and pepper. It's tomato.
You're really good at this. Sorry about that. I don't think I'm gonna finish this.
You're gonna eat the whole thing together because it gives you like the olive. I don't know. I can't help you there. But the others, it's like a.
You have no idea how much I'm not enjoying this. I'm holding it together. I am so not pleased. All this free fucking food.
And this shit is ass. This shit is dry and burnt as fuck.
Throwing it away. The color that you picked have different topics that you talk about. So I picked. I guess so. I think it's just a nice way to spark conversation.
Yeah, probably so.
My question says, if you had to give a TED talk without any prep, what topic would you choose? And then it has some other ones, like, if you could relive one of your accomplishments, which one would it be? What's something you recently came across that gave you hope or inspiration? and how do you define work-life balance, and why do you think it's important in today's professional environment? Networking event was lit. Got some contacts. Now I'm trying to find what after parties they got going on. Thought I'd update the people right quick. And yeah.
Follow my new one.
I thought I saw you posted on that one.
Okay, I don't know. Let's see which one you follow. That's the new one now. That was my old one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so I had to
sleep. Oh, I am following.
Okay, okay, yeah, so you locked here. In.
Yep.
All right, thank you.
Can I take a flick real quick?
Yeah, yeah, I come right there. We can do it in front of the booth.
Oh.
Shoot.
Yeah,
bro. Thank you.
But yeah, please keep doing what you do.
I will, I will.
Great.
Thank you. Thank you.
He may not even be the real owner of this here shop. It's probably a white man done something to look this damn good. I ain't never seen a nigga do no shit like this now. Yeah. So we need to find the real owner of this here, because it ain't him. Yeah, that's a white man in that picture right there. He don't look like that man. So, yeah. This is too good to be done by a nigga. There ain't no nigga ever done no shit like this now. Never in my life.
And just like that, DreamCon is officially over. Oh, also, this is all I got left. If you remember, I had 2 full green duffel bags. Now, both those duffel bags are empty. That's empty duffel bags. So the only thing really was the case, and then that's the tent. So that's it. I'm late. My flight's at 6. Pre-checkers line is still long. I can only imagine what general admissions is. Just got through TSA. It's 4:33. I think I'm gonna make it. I made it. I pulled off the plane and they got me outside. I never seen this shit before. But hey, We made it to California. From one adventure to the next, the grind don't stop. Who knows where I'll end up next? Fuck around, catch me in Dubai on a Tuesday. All right, so let me give you a little update on what's going on. I have a mission with the military on today, right after DreamCon. When I got to the airport, it was a connecting flight. I went from Austin to Dallas, Dallas to California. When I got to Dallas, though, when I got on my plane, I was sitting in my seat. Another person on my mission, Tally, which he was in another video I did a mission with him before, clip. He got on the plane. I mean, we all going to the same place, so it's not crazy that he was on the plane, but I didn't know he was going to be here. So I say all I say is, he here now, so I'm about to wait out for him. And that's how we met up. That was the premises of, you just see, oh, where the hell he came from? Oh yeah, he got on the plane in Dallas. And Henley's on this mission too. So this is gonna be lit. But Henley wasn't on that plane, so he must be getting on another plane. But he should be here now. We're all meeting up in California, so.